So if you would, recall with me now one of those warm evenings in the City of Love. Paris is everybody's mistress. Every man has his own secret memories of Paris.
The last time I saw Paris, her heart was warm and gay.
I heard the laughter of her heart in every street cafe.
Hey, garçon.
Oui, monsieur.
Tell me, have you seen a girl?
A girl? What kind of girl?
Any kind. My boat leaves tomorrow. Say, do you think that girl sitting over there would be offended if I said hello?
Monsieur, she has winked at you. She has dropped her handkerchief, and right now, she's smiling at you. What does that usually mean to you, eh?
She's a cop.
The last time I saw Paris, her trees were dressed for spring.
And lovers walked beneath the trees, and birds found songs to sing.
Brian, I enjoyed having dinner with you.
Oh, I enjoyed being with you.
Oh, it was delicious. The champagne, the duckling, the crêpe Suzette, the brandy.
It was nice. Oh, by the way, here's my half of the check. Say, you're quite a doll. Do you have a husband?
Mais non.
Engaged?
Mais non.
Boyfriend?
Mais non.
I don't know who this guy May No is, but he must be a powerhouse.
Brian, I'm afraid I must go home.
Oh, but it's early. We've got a world of time.
Oh, but I must.
Come on, this is our night. Let's give your mom and dad a chance to go to sleep.
That's just it. I live alone, and there's no one to feed the parakeet.
Alone? Well, hey, let's hurry home and cram that little bastard full of birdseed.
Taxi! Taxi!
I dodge the same old taxi cabs that I had dodged for years. The echo of their squeaky horns was music to my ears.
Phew. How much further up is your apartment?
Only 6 more flights.
No wonder you don't worry about living alone. These stairs make a wonderful chaperone.
Brian, you never told me what kind of work you do.
Oh, I do a little bit of freelance writing. I used to sell vacuum cleaners, but I had to quit because I couldn't give a demonstration without hiding under a table.
Oh, I love the Americans. They are so debonair, so handsome.
If you insist.
What country are you from?
Huh?
Well, here we are. Come on in. I'll turn on the light.
Do you mind leaving it off?
As you wish, chérie.
I'll close the drapes. There, that's better.
Much better.
By the way, I brought you a little gift. It's a dead chipmunk. You see, when a dog brings a piece of roadkill into the house and drops it on the carpet, what he's really saying is, I love you.
Oh, my. You have such a way with words. Come here and kiss me.
Don't mind if I do.
The last time I saw Paris, her heart was warm and gay. No matter how they change her, I'll remember that way.
The last time I saw Paris.
Oh, yes, right on time with that one, Chris. I say, Lois, how harrowing it must have been for you to give birth to that monstrosity.
Yeah, that must have been tough, having Chris.
Well, how should I put this? Imagine squeezing a Subaru out of your vagina.
Well, I can imagine the Subaru, but I'm afraid I can't imagine myself with a vagina.
I can imagine you with a vagina.
Is that a gay joke?
That is a gay joke.
We have such a colorful family, don't we?
Yeah, it is swell. Especially you, Lois. You know, I gotta tell you, my life sucked big time before I met you.
Well, go ahead and tell me.